Next comes the making of nationalism in Europe. Till mid 18th century, there was no concept of nation state in Europe. Society and politics was dominated aristocracy. Actually, society and politics was dominated by aristocracy, meaning people, those who were in the higher level, people who belonged to high class, they were the dominant in the society and also in politics. To the west, the land was formed by tenants and small owners, while in Eastern and Central Europe by vast estates which were cultivated by serfs. Emergence of working and middle classes due to industrialization in 19th century. So working and middle class due to industrialization. Industrialization is nothing but industries were brought into existence. So there were so many industries which was constructed, and the obviously when the industries were constructed, the mechanical power and also the human power had also increased during the 19th century. Educated, liberal, middle class popularized abolition of aristocratic privileges. Next to liberal nationalism in political sphere, in economic sphere. So in under political sphere, government by consent, end of autocracy, adoption of constitution, abolition of property rights, equality before law, representative governments through parliament. So this happened in the political sphere under liberal nationalism. Then in economic sphere, freedom for market. Economic is nothing but the market, how economical it was. So something is related to the economy of that nation. Freedom for market, removal of state imposed restriction and movement of goods and capital. In 1834, a customs union, Zollverein, was formed. The union abolished tariff barriers and reduced the number of currencies from over 30 to 2. So this happened during in economic sphere during liberal nationalism. And what is liberal nationalism? It was also known as civic nationalism, which is identified by political philosophers who believe in an inclusive form of nationalism that adheres to traditional liberal values of freedom, tolerance, equality, and individual rights. So basically, this is common for everyone, which includes that is the freedom, tolerance, equality, and individual rights were common for everyone. That is called as liberal nationalism. That's what you're seeing, liberal nationalism in political sphere and also in economic sphere. So new conservatism after 1815. After defeat of Napoleon, Europe governments were driven by the spirit of conservatism. Britain, Russia, Prussia and Austria drew the Treaty of Vienna in 1815. Main motive was to undo the changes initiated by Napoleon and to restore monarchy. So prohibition